हेलो क्लास, गुड आफ्टरनून, वेलकम टू द कंप्यूटर नेटवर्क प्रैक्टिकल। सो बिफोर आई स्टार्ट लेट मी नो, कैन यू हियर मी? यस क्लास, लेट मी नो, कैन यू हियर मी? यू कैन ड्रॉप मी अ मैसेज और यू कैन रेज योर हैंड। So today we are going to perform experiment number three. Two we have already completed in our previous practical session. So this experiment number three is about implementing static routing using three router. Using two router we implemented in our last practical session. Okay, have you all performed that? And do not forget to submit pre post Viva question and worksheet on time. This time you are given, you know, for example, today we are performing experiment number three, then you have to submit the worksheet by tomorrow itself. There is guideline that is received from e-governance. So follow the deadline to avoid any, you know, issues or problem. Yes, class, should we start? Are you with me? Let me know. Yes, Diksha. Fine. So for this, I'm sharing my screen with you all. I'm sharing my entire screen with you all. Here it is. I have shared my screen. Once it is visible, let me know. Yes, class, please let me know whether my screen is visible to you. Can you see my screen? Because once I will enter in packet tracer, I will not come here to confirm. Thank you, Diksha, for letting me know. You can change your status also, whether it is visible to you all. Can you hear me, class? Let me know by changing your status. Can you hear me? Only one student is responding. It means others are not able to hear me. There are two more students. Palak, Neha. Okay, fine. So this is, I'm sharing. The Cisco packet tracer. Let me close this. Okay, now whether this packet tracer is visible? I hope it is visible to you all. This packet tracer window. Okay, all right. Fine. So today we are going to implement experiment number three, that is implement static routing using three routers. All right. So we are gonna perform that. For this task, we need three routers. So in network category, come to this subcategory, select the router. So I'm gonna use three router, router one. This is router two, router 3, you can connect n number of router. Okay, no issue at all. Now let's take some switches. Switch 3 switches. Okay, fine. Now I need some end devices. This end devices PC, I think 2 PCs is more than enough. 2 PC in each local area network. So this thing I have done. I have deployed all the networking devices. So next step, I want to connect my PC to this switch. So class, let me know which cable should I use. Are you with me? Let me know. I have deployed every network devices. So which cable should I use to connect my PC to the switch? One reply from Palak, and it's straight through cable. Yeah, yes, right. So let's go to the connection. In connection, this is straight through cable and this is crossover cable. So let's take this straight through cable. This PC one, fast Ethernet, connected to switch. This PC two is connected to switch. Then come to the other network. Here I'm connecting this to the fast Ethernet. Fast Ethernet to this. Similarly, let's do it quickly. Hooked up all the devices and now connect. Now again task is that I want to connect my switch to the router. So again, what cables should I use? I have connected my PC to the switch. I want to connect my switch to the PC. I'm again returning to the chat box. Yes, class, are you with me? Any reply? I'm not getting any response from you all. Do you remember which cable should I use? You can reply. There's only one reply. What about other? Akshar, Tarvin, Avinash, Dhruv, Himanshu, Verma, Hitesh, and all, where you all are. Any other reply? Is it the same? Yes, class, let me know. Only Palak is replying. What about other? I will not proceed further until you respond. Yes, which cable? Straight or crossover to connect my switch to the router? Yes, let me know. Okay, fine. These are of 2 different types, so I will be using this. So do we have fast Ethernet, gigabit Ethernet? Gigabit Ethernet, okay. Let's cancel it. Okay, fine. Now I want to connect these routers. So I can show you the physical view of this router, physical configuration. So you have this gigabit interface. You can also increase the interfaces if this interface is not sufficient. So I will tell you how you can increase that. From here, you can add to your router. Fine. Now it's time to connect our routers. So for router, what cable should I use, class? I want to connect the routers. For router, again reply, which cable? Only router is remaining. It's cross. Okay, fine. Let's take this cross cable. I want to connect this router, gigabit one interface, to this router, gigabit one interface. Now this router, two interface with this one. Let one interface be empty. So now I have done all the, you know, the hookup, physical connection. So what is the next thing I should perform? Next important thing after deploying. Yes, Ganesh, you can use automatic connecting wires, no issue. But to understand which cable you are taking, you must remember. You must understand also. In automatic, you will not understand which type of cable that particular is taking automatically. Now, next task is provide the IP addresses. Okay, let me provide the IP addresses, but as this in the routing, I will be requiring those information. So let me take a note. For example, this interface, for example, is 10.0.0.1, and for this interface, this is my another network, for example, 10.20.0.1 I will be taking, and this interface, suppose that 30.0.0.1 I will be taking. So this will be the IP address for this interface of the router. So do you remember my one sentence? The IP address for, do you remember my one sentence in my theory class? Each interface of the router, you know, represent different network. Do you remember that? Every interface represent the different network. I hope you all remember that. Yes, class, let me know. I want to see respond from you all. You remember? So that's why I have given this IP address to this interface. Similarly, let me take a note. This IP address will be having 10.0.0.2 IP address. This will be having 10.0.3. Similarly, this IP address will be 20.0.0.2. I'm taking a note so that while this, as this is a complex configuration, so that I may not forget, that is why I'm taking the note. This is in another network, this is 30.0.0.2, and this will become 30.0.0.3. And this interface, this is another interface on router 1. It is connected to router 2. So this is another interface, and this interface represent another network. So let me say it is 11.0.0.1. On router 2, this interface, it is 11.0.0.2. This is in same interface. So let me make it up. Let me drag it up. Okay, fine. So is it clear till now or any issue? Class, let me know quickly. Give me your quick feedback. Till now, you having any problem, you can ask me. Similarly, here this interface is another network. So let me take it 12.0.0.1. This I am taking note so that I may not forget. 12.0.0.2. Final, all the information is now populated on this workspace. Yes, problem. Yes, class. Is it all clear? Quickly, let me know by changing your status. Is it all clear till now? Now, most important thing, after taking a note, it is a good practice so that you may not forget. So let me provide the PC IP address. Click on the PC, click on the desktop, then click on the IP configuration. In IP configuration, the IP of this PC is 10.0.0.2 and the default subnet mask. What is the default gateway? Can anyone reply me? What is default gateway for this network? LAN 1, we are having LAN 1, LAN 2, LAN 3. I'm returning to chat box to see your reply. Yes, class, I will not proceed further until you reply. What is the default gateway for LAN 1? You just see, have a look on it, and then tell me. Anyone? Is there anyone? The default gateway is nothing but the address of the router. Yes, Palak, that's great. Default gateway, nothing but the router's address. Yes, great, Palak, you are going. Why question mark? You are not confirmed? Be sure. That one. Fine. So here I will be providing 10.0.0.1. What is the IP address of the router connecting to that interface? Fine. I have provided the IP address on first PC. Similarly, I will repeat the process. I will repeat the process with every PC. Its IP address is 2. It is 10.0.0.3. So default gateway again 10.0.0.1. The IP address of PC number 2 is configured. Similarly, I'm going in net ID, another network. This is, I will give 20.2. So I'm remembering 20.0.0.2. So what is the default gateway for this? 20.0.0.1. Where it come from? This interface of the router having this IP address. Yes, is it clear, class? Let me do it for the second PC. In second PC, on second PC, it is 20.0.0.3. Fine. The IP address of two network has been configured. Now the IP address of the third network is to be configured. So let's click on this. It's 30. Go to the desktop, go on this. It is this 30.0.2, first IP address of the first PC, and this you can give here quickly. Okay, fine. The IP address of this PC, similarly, you can configure. It is 3. Fine, it is 3 default. So now the IP address of every PC has been provided. So on this interface, git 0/0, the IP address, now we have to configure the router. Till now, we have configured the PC. Every PC in the network has been configured. Till now, any problem, class? Is it all clear how to configure the IP addresses of PC? I'm here in the chat box. Quickly let me know. Is it all clear? Thank you, Pulak, for letting me know. So now next important task is how to configure the router. And this is our the main task today. So let's do it. Just click on router one. On router one, the router configuration window will open. So on this window, you can have the physical view of the router. It should be turned on. It should not be off. Okay, fine. Click on the configuration. Then see here. On router one, gigabit 0/0 is connected to LAN one, and we have to provide IP address. For that, you can give command either in CLI, in command mode, you can work, or in GUI, you can give it directly. So enable command is to enable the router. Then configure terminal. It means you are going to configure the terminal. Then you will type interface gigabit 0/0. Then after gigabit 0/0, you have to provide the IP address. IP add. What is the IP address? IP with the help of this command 10.0.0.1. This is the default gateway also. So IP address, IP space address, then IP address, then subnet mask. And this command is no shutdown. So can you see this? Now this line turned green. So again, you have configured the interface one. Do you remember the interface gigabit 0/1 is connected to second router? So this IP address you have to give. Similarly, it is on another interface on another network, that is 11.0.0.1. Be careful, no shutdown. So I have configured this line, but it is still red. Why? What is the reason? Because we have not turned it on from router 2. This line is not turned on from the router 2. So let's click on the router 2, go to the config, and this, it has two interface, gigabit 0/0 is having the IP address 20.0.0.1. no shutdown. Yes, this is done. It can say now it is turned green. Now click on the gigabit 0/1 is connected to the router one. Click on this. So what is the IP address here? 11.0.0.2. subnet mask, no shutdown. So can you see it is now green? It's turned on from both the sided. That's why it is green. So you will repeat the same process on the third router also. Let's go to the third router. Click on it. The router 6 interface will open. Here you can see configuration. This, click on the configuration tab. Click on gigabit Ethernet 0/0 and 0/1. gigabit 0/0. It is connected to which network? It is connected to that IP address. For this, it is 30.0.0.1. See the follow the nomenclature, follow the symmetry. Now you see it is turned on. It is green now. Now this interface gigabit 0/1, gigabit 0/1, its IP address is on 12.0.0.2. See, whatever I have decided, I have configured. So let's close it. If you why this is not green, turned on, might be here this gigabit 0/2, I have to configure that also. So how you can identify this is red? It is on, this interface is turned on from router 3, but it is not here set up on this interface. So the IP address for this interface is 12.0.0.1. Now no shutdown. Here you can see it is green. Now we have configured the IP address on every machine and on every router. Now the most, let's save this topology. Today it is, you know, March 2. We are performing static routing using three routers. Fine. The next task, what is, if you see, let me simulate this network. So if you are here and sending the packet from PC1 to PC2, click on the play hand free. So it is transmitted to this PC and here it is in progress. You can see now network 1, LAN 1 is configured successfully and the packet delivery is successful. Now click on this. This time I'm checking network 2. Click hand free. Fine. Let me, it is genuine that if you are communicating for the first time, the communication may fail, right? Some packet may fail. So in LAN 2 also configured successfully. Now the packets are, message is from being sent from one PC to second PC. Now the communication is successful. Similarly, let me check this also. And here it is in progress. The packet is transmitted to the switch 3. Here it is in progress. Fine. Receiving back, acknowledging. So all the three local area network, they are configured successfully. Now what if I want to send packet? Now see, here it is successful. This is reconnecting. Till now, any issue? So I was saying, if I let me delete all communication. So what if I want to send message from LAN 1 to LAN 2? So let's see whether it succeed or not. It is returning back, and it is returning back, not going to this router 2, not going to this router 2, because this packet is not finding the path from router 1 to router 2. So that's why this communication failed. It means we have not configured the routing information. Let me just do it now. I'm going to perform static routing now. Are you with me, class? Configuration of router 3rd. This is router 3rd. One interface is connecting to this network. This interface is connecting to this router 2. This is. But if I'm sending message from PC1 to PC2, it's being transmitted. But I want to send packet from this PC to this network. This is not reachable because you have not maintained the routing table. As it is a static routing table ping, let me ping this PC, this 10.10.0.0.0.3. So it's replying. It means the connection is established successful. But if I am trying to ping the PC from network 20, so it's saying destination host unreachable. Have you seen this error before? Destination host unreachable. Have you seen this? It means you have not maintained the routing table. Till now, class, are you with me? It will take only 10 minutes to configure the static routing. Are you with me? Quickly let me know. In one LAN, its communication is successful, but when I'm trying to access some PC from another, it is saying this. So let me configure this. I'm clicking on router 1. On router 1, just click on configuration tab, click on static. After this routing, we will do dynamic routing and we will use RIP protocol. You know what is RIP? But still focus on this, focus on static routing only. If you are able to perform this static routing, then dynamic routing configuration is very easy. Okay, fine. I am on router 1. So what command should I give? Either in CLI or in GUI. So on router 1, so I want to connect to the network 20.0.0.0, and subnet mask is 255.0.0.0. Next hop. What is the next hop address, next router address, this interface? Next hop from router 1, it is 11.0.0.2. Let me add this. This is static. The route is maintained. This is a static router. So here, the command you will type, IP route. Give the network IP to which you want to connect, give the subnet mask, and give the next hop. I'm done with the configuration of router 1. Now, if you see, you can send now this packet from 2 to this PC on LAN 2, but it will not reply back. Why? It will not send back because it is not having its routing table. See, the packet is sent from router 1 to router 2. So we have to configure that also. Let first complete the configuration part. Click on router 2. Click on static. So on static, I am router 1. I'm maintaining the routing table. So I want to connect to the network 10.0.0.0. It means this network. Can you see my mouse pointer? This network, LAN 1. Subnet mask 255.0.0.0. What is the next hop? Next hop is 11.0.0.1. Okay, fine. This side I am connected. But one thing, I am on router 1, router 2, sorry, router 2. I have to connect to this network also. So let me add this also. I want to connect to this 30.0.0.0 on which interface is next hop? Next hop is, it is 12.0.0.2. Let me add this. Okay, router 2 is configured properly. Now come to the router 3. On router 3, but the configuration of router 1 is not complete. You have said that you are connecting to this network, 20 network, via what? Via this router 2. But from router 1, I want to connect to the router 3 also. So what is the network on that interface? It is 30.0.0.0. Subnet mask 255.0.0.0. Next hop, in this case, be careful. The next hop is not this. In this case, the next hop is this router interface of the router 2. So this is 11.0.0.2. Let me add this. Now the configuration of router 1 is done completely. Router 2 done completely. Router 3, one thing is remaining. Go to the static routing. In static routing, you want to connect to which network? 10.0.0.0. Subnet mask 255.0.0.0. What is the next hop? I am on router 3. I want to connect to the network on router 1. So next hop is 12.0.0.1. Not this 11.0.0. Let me add this. Okay. I also want to connect to the network 20. And for that, bingo. Well done. Now I have configured it. Now I have configured every router. So now let me check. If you want, you can have some note. This is router 1, I'm saying. This is R2. If I write in every BSN, is it fine? This is R3. And in this case, this is R1. Now you can understand easily. So now I want to connect to this PC 20.0.0.2 from the LAN 1. Okay, fine. This is my LAN 1. This is, I'm saying, LAN 2. This is LAN 2. All configured properly. I have to check the connectivity only. LAN 3. Okay, fine. These are the three LANs. Let me save this. This is my source machine. I am on 10.0.0.2. Let me check this IP address. This, it was saying the destination host not reachable. So it's 20.3. Let me hit enter. Wait for its reply. it is normal that first packet may fail, but it has sent 4 ICMP packet and it is see 3 packet, loss of 1 packet, there is 25% loss only. Let me ping it again. This time the ping is coming from the LAN 2 PC. Now let me ping the LAN 3 PC. I have to do nothing, I have to change it 30. Now only one part is remaining, that is the simulation part. Generally one packet may fail, but if it is configured properly, it may reply yes, it is replying. So two packet lost, 50% loss is there when I'm connecting to LAN 3. Again I'm pinging, this time it is also bingo. So it means I can send packets from LAN 1 to LAN 2, LAN 3. I am again returning to LAN 2. Let me see whether I can ping some PC from here. Ping 10.0.0.2 to check the connectivity. Yes, the PC from LAN 1 is replying. Let me check the PC from LAN 3. I am inside LAN 2. The PC from LAN 3 is also replying. Bingo. Great. I'm on LAN 3. Let me ping LAN 1, local area networking 1. Ping 10.0.0.2. Yes, the reply is coming from the LAN 1 also. Let me ping LAN 2, PC of LAN 2. Yes, it is also replying. So we have configured static routing successfully. Yes, class. Is it all clear? Are you with me? There are 34 students. So if I show you the simulation, that will also work because it is pinging. I was working in this real-time mode. Now click on the simulation. This will show you only the simulation, nothing else. So this is my sender PC. This is my receiver source. This is destination. Let's click. The packet is transmitted to switch 1, from switch 1 to router 1. Bingo, it's transmitted to router 2. From router 2, it's finding the path. It is going to the PC second of the LAN 2. Now, acknowledgement is coming from. Great. We have successfully implemented these 3 local area networking by using the static implementation, static routing. So this time, this is my source machine, this is my destination machine. Let's check it out. Just play hand-free, going to switch 1, from switch 1 to router 1, from router 1 to router 2, great. From router 2 to router 3, again, great. Fine, it's working fine. The packet is sent to that network, now it is returning back. Acknowledgement to router 3, to router 1, to this router 1, to switch 1, to the source machine. Great, we have simulated this also. Fine. I hope. Do you have any doubt, class? I hope it was, the full of hands-on session. You learn something new in this session. So in the next session, I will divide you into group where you can implement it by yourself. I will give you some tasks. Before leaving the session, just give me a quick feedback by changing your status so that I can know. And if you have any doubt, any question, you may ask. Thank you, class. Do join on the time in the day.